One of my favorite things in the world is to find out that there is a really basic thing that I thought that everybody freaking knew that it turns out that a whole bunch of people don't know. And then I get to make a video like this where I tell you something that you're going to love. You're going to love this. A whole bunch of people seem to misunderstand how Crossfire handles binding. And that may be because you came from FreeSky and you just assume it works the same. It doesn't. Binding in Crossfire is so much better, easier, simpler, and faster than with FreeSky. And if you didn't know that, I bet I'm going to tell you something that you did. You're going to learn something today. The first thing I want to show you is a simpler way maybe to bind a Crossfire receiver. And that is, check this out. You might know that you can control your Crossfire receiver by going into your radio, by going to the Tools menu in a FreeSky radio, or an OpenTX radio rather, and go to Crossfire Configure, and then go Micro TX, and then put it into binding mode. And that's fine. But a lot of people find that to be a little tedious, especially with Lua scripts and so on. Lua scripts are tedious and all those button clicks. What if there was an easier way? You can put your Crossfire receiver into bind mode just by pushing this button once. Did you know that already? Have I gotten to the thing that I'm going to tell you that you didn't yet know? Stick with me. So we can just push this button and it goes into bind mode. And bind mode is blinking green. What about on the receiver? And this receiver, the bind button is buried up in here, and sometimes on some of you guys' quads, it's even more buried. And I've heard people complain, oh, I updated the firmware on my Crossfire module, and now I gotta push the button on all my receivers. What a hassle. No, you don't. And that's the other thing I wanna make sure you know. When you very first get a brand new Crossfire receiver, it goes into bind mode instantly as soon as you power it up. And then, if you want to change the bind to a different module, you have to push the bind button. And the point of that, I guess, is that they don't want somebody else to like accidentally secretly bind to your quad and steal your bind. But as long as you're binding to the same module, you never have to hit the bind button ever again. Let's do the initial bind. So this one came from the factory, so it should just auto-bind. So I've got my controller in bind mode. Now watch. You can see the LED right here. Red LED. Blinking red LED. Blue. Blinking blue LED. Now that means that this module has communicated with this receiver. They are ready to bind, but the blinking blue LED means a firmware update is needed on the receiver. Again, you can do this from in the Lua script, but if you don't want to go to the Lua script, just push the bind button one more time. Blinking red. Maybe I didn't get to it fast enough. Let me do it again. I think there's a timeout. Binding. I think you have like 30 seconds. I talk too much, go figure. Let's wait for this to go blinking blue. Push it. Now it goes solid blue. And if we look here, we can see the light in the receiver is solid green. Now it is uploading the firmware to the receiver over the wireless. This will take a couple minutes. Just sit and wait. Just wait. The next thing that'll happen is that the receiver LED will begin rapidly blinking as the upload of firmware is finished and it is loading the firmware. It's really important that you don't power the receiver down during this. If you do screw it up, there is a way to recover it, but we're just going to wait while that happens. One thing to keep in mind is that anytime you update the firmware on your Crossfire module, for any reason, you will need to rebind your receivers because that is how you update the firmware on the receivers. And this is pissing some people off because, like, I just did a video about Crossfire multibind where you can bind more than one module to the same quad and you can just switch between your controllers as much as you want. People were like, oh, I just did this and now I have to rebind all 15 of my quads. You don't, oh, see, fast blinking, it's loading. You don't have to hit the bind button. Just put the module into bind, then power up the receiver, and then wait and update the firmware. There you go. Look, solid green, they're bound, it's done. You never had to push the bind button on the receiver at all. Sometimes you have to power cycle it before it goes solid green again. I'm not sure why, but that's it. No Lua script, no pushing buttons on the receiver, none of that nonsense. Crossfire has made it so freaking simple and easy. And that's like, that's why you got Crossfire. This, like, it's like one of the main reasons you got it was how easy it is to do the firmware updates and the binding, I thought. But it turns out apparently a whole lot of people didn't know about this, and now you do. What else? If you ever get into a situation where the Crossfire receiver is going red, green, green, red, green, green, or maybe green, 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 that means that it's borked its firmware update somehow. There is a fix. It's called TBS Crossfire Emergency Recovery. There's a button press sequence that you do that will restore it to it keeps a backup copy of a good firmware on it. And what you do is you go through that process. I'll put a link to that. There's a tutorial about how to do that. I'll put a link to that down in the video description. You can check it out. After you do the emergency recovery, then you rebind it and you re-update the firmware just like I just did, and then it's fine and it comes back again 99% of the time. Anytime you've got a Crossfire receiver and it doesn't work like just like you just saw it do the Crossfire emergency recovery, and then you should be able to go through this and it should be fine. There you go. That's it. Short and sweet. Happy flying.
What are you doing in here? The least you could do is subscribe or join my Patreon, or, like, just, here's another video I picked out for you. Jeez.